Hello everybody, this is Bloverking here with the walkthrough let's play that was always supposed to happen, but never really did. This is, as you can see, NASCAR Rumble, the prequel to the Rumble Racing game I actually played for you guys a while back. I always meant to play this game. I actually planned on doing it first. I think I got like 3 videos up of it a long time ago. And the thing starts up again. Anyways, I meant to do this a while ago, but I didn't. I had a stupid looking camera, it didn't look good, so I decided not to do it. And then when I got a better camera, I decided to do Rumble Racing instead. So now, it is time to play NASCAR Rumble. Hopefully this looks okay on screen. I can't do the smoothening, I guess you could say. On my PS3, it looks like crap on screen right now. But hopefully on the video it doesn't look too bad, because right now it looks so bad on screen. Anyways, we're going to do this championship style, going through the entire game, unlocking stuff. I don't know if I'll wait till the very end of the playthrough to get all the, wrenches, which, in Rumble Racing it was eggs, in this game it's wrenches. Don't know if I'll wait till the end to do that, or if I'll have like a video or something. Midway through, kind of showing all the ones I've missed. I won't be getting them on my way through the game, because honestly I don't remember where all of them are. So to get this started, I am going to be Bill Elliott, who was my favorite driver at the time. Now if you don't know, it's Casey Kane, because he replaced Bill Elliott, but Bill Elliott's still one of my favorite drivers. And we will get the, I guess this is called the Gold Rush Championship, on its way. Do my old moniker. Might as well do that. There we go. And hopefully the audio sounds okay. I'm kind of using the microphone that's built into my new laptop, which is the only reason why I'm even recording this. Because I bought a new laptop, but hopefully it sounds okay. Especially while I'm driving and all the banging is going to be happening. Because odds are this game is pretty loud with all of the smashing and crashing. Wow. Gotta love this game. I do have to use the D-pad because I can't figure out how to get my analog stick to work. I don't feel like messing around with it to do that. So odds are I'm gonna be a little rusty at first because I have not played this game in a very long time. Probably since I've actually tried to do that one. Ever since I tried to do that one walkthrough of it way back. But, I mean, I used to play this all the time as a kid. I think this game came out in like 2000. I think that's what it said on the disc. I'm pretty sure I got it in Christmas of 2000, because I know I got it for Christmas. And it was like one of the best days of my life, because it was my first video game besides Pokemon that I could call my own. And I played the crap out of it. Like, I played it so much. Pretty much any time I wasn't in school or outside playing with my friends, I was inside playing this game. I'm gonna get hit by that. I was inside playing this because I wasn't the best at the NASCAR 2000 game that my dad had, or NASCAR 98. That's the first game I remember playing in 98. But I wasn't very good at that. But I was really good at this game. Used to play with my dad all the time. Until he started getting Finders sick keepers. While playing it. I don't want to get frozen. Now you're really and I still did, after Try slowing down. Because in this game, there's a little bit different hazards compared to Rumble Racing. You have tornadoes that screw you up. You saw kind of what I did, or what happened to me earlier, where I kind of flew around. Almost looks like I flew over, but not quite. You have storms, which they kind of like block your view, they kind of shake your steering around a little bit, make it a little bit harder to control. The worst has got to be the freeze, because in Rumble Racing you could kind of still turn your car, and like as it went on, you could kind of, it was easier to turn, but in this game you can't turn at all. I mean, you just, if there's a lot of turns in the track you're on, I mean, you're just done. So in order to avoid those, if you slow down to low, I think like 70 miles an hour, which is probably going to be like the speed limit on all these roads, they'll just pass right by you. which could work out in your favor, or it could essentially cost you the race. I know it's happened to me a few times where I slowed down. Been a car past me and I couldn't pass them back before the line. Think we're gonna run out. So you can see Twister passes right through me. But then Jeremy Mayfield, I have no clue how he did not get completely demolished by that tornado. But he got up to me. The Twister, let's see what happens this time. That time, I don't know if you guys can really see in the rear mirror with, I mean, on my screen it's so pixelated I could barely tell. That's Jeremy Mayfield behind me. This power-up I keep getting, if you see there, it's called the Joker, I'm pretty sure. Never use it when you're in first place, because bad things happen. Of course, the time I try to use it to show you what would happen, I get a pretty good item. And I get another good item with it. But usually you get, like, the best... Oh, crap. Yep, and as you can see, I cannot turn at all, and it's the last lap. But yeah, this guy here pretty much will help you gain traction, especially if you have like an oil slick. But the Joker usually gives you the oil slick or gives you the bad gas thing. Gosh, Jeremy Mayfield, like, you on meth or something? Okay, I know. Yeah, that's such an old joke, but I haven't been able to make it. screw the tornado, I'm just gonna go for it. It's the last lap and we're pretty close to the finish line. It's good to be the king. Okay, that worked out pretty well. Probably the bunny is over 2 seconds behind me. And I'm pretty sure on this track, if you look on the map, the start-finish line, I think, is in, like, the complete wrong spot. It's like it's showing I'm going by the start-finish line now. And that's when I go across the start-finish line. But anyways, I won. I did not have the fastest lap. Most people actually had faster laps than I did, besides Dale Earnhardt, the Intimidator. Forgot he was actually even in this game. Still alive when this came out. But let's move on to the next race, since these races and these championships are 4 laps instead of 3. So I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to do a whole championship in one video. I guess I'll probably do it for this first video to see how long the time is. I see I'm already at like 7.5 minutes. So that put me at probably had like a 1 minute intro of me talking about stupid stuff. So put me at like about 20 minutes, which should be fine. Forget a few of these tracks are actually are very similar to ones that are in Rumble Racing. I actually think the last track we were on was on that. I don't know, they changed them up a little bit, so they'll be a little bit different. A lot of them are the same though. I think of this one. I remember this one because it has the big drop here, which I thought was really cool. I don't think this one was in Rumble Racing. I'll probably, one that really looks like it, I'll remember when I see it. Pretty sure there's one, I think it was called Passing Through in Rumble Racing. I know that one's in this game. Fall, no, I don't know if Falls Down is or not. None of the city ones are the same. I think there's a beach one that's the same. And ooh, need some roof flaps in this game. Come on. Here's a shortcut. Just splash through this wall. And, you know, going back and playing this game, the graphics look so bad. But this is a PlayStation 1 game, so you can't expect too much. But it is a late PlayStation 1 game. I mean, when you think about it, PlayStation 2 might have been out when this game came out, so you'd think that it would look better, but oh well. I mean, it's an arcade NASCAR game that probably sold maybe at most like 500,000 copies, so you can't really expect much, considering that it's probably had a super small budget. I got a pretty decent lead, so I'll show you guys. This is the one key I remember. I'll just show you what it looks like. It's this guy here. These are what unlocks new cars. There's that one, and there's another one that I seem to always remember. But that'll be on a later track. Like I said, can't promise that I'll do that for all the keys, because I don't remember all of them. I wish I did.
we'll keep the track warm for you.
I might even have to look up a walkthrough or something on it. Probably once I get to the tracks, I'll remember them. And if I have a big enough lead, maybe I'll just get them while I'm playing, like I did this time. But definitely no promises. In this case, you guys were wondering why I haven't really posted any videos for a while. It's because in April, my computer broke. The charger melted. It melted both the computer and the charger, so that kind of sucked. Bought a new charger for it, melted that one too, so it's pretty much broken. So I decided to wait and save up for a really nice computer. So I got myself a really nice Asus laptop that has like a built-in graphics card and all that stuff. It was like $1,000. It's super nice. I love it. It's really good for iRacing. I bought an NR2003 for it as well. So I might do some videos with that game. I'll wait and see. So for pretty much the past, what would that be? 6 months, 7 months, I haven't had a computer, so I couldn't really record anything with my HD PVR. I pretty much had to either use any sort of video thing that my PlayStation could use, so that's why I like that NASCAR 14 video was out, because I could just export those replays to my PlayStation, and then I put them on my family's Mac at the time when we had it, and just edited it with like iMovie and did that. And then unfortunately too, with another stroke of bad luck, I actually, this storm is probably so loud on the video, it's probably completely droning me out. But unfortunately, my PlayStation in, I think early August, I got the yellow light of death again, like the billionth time, so I'm actually using my family's PlayStation. So unfortunately what that means, since they have the super slim version of it, is that my NASCAR 07 playthrough is pretty much on a permanent halt. I still haven't decided if I wanted to fix my old PlayStation or not, to get that save file, or maybe even play it again. But since I lost the save file, I can't really transport it over to a PlayStation 2. And I also really can't really record it on a PlayStation 2 since my PlayStation 2 broke. Everything just broke this year for whatever reason, even though I had a string of good luck of things not breaking. So pretty much PS2 games can't really record. That's why I'm actually doing this playthrough, because that's one of the few things I can do without just recording the Eutechnics NASCAR games, which get boring because only one of those games you can do blowers in. And that really makes me mad. If they make one for like the PS4, they really need to add blowers again. Because I just don't play those games much because of it. I mean, online's okay, but people always just play Daytona or Talladega, and I hate those tracks. It takes very little skill to drive those in that game. And even if it did take skill, it's pretty much... holy cow, I have a 24-second lead with spinning out and gaining. Anyways, what was I saying? Oh yeah, those tracks took no skill to drive, and the net code in those games is so bad that you can't bump draft, you really can't do anything in them. So I like doing actual racetracks like Bristol or Charlotte, or probably one of my favorites is like Las Vegas or Kansas. But it'll be races or tracks on those games, so I just never play them. And actually, my NASCAR 14 is stuck in my dead PlayStation, so I can't even really play that at all. So, that's probably why I'll do some NR2003 videos, just to kind of make up for it. And you know, thinking about it, me talking on this is probably not even syncing up with the video, since there's a lag between what I'm seeing on screen and what's actually being recorded on the laptop. So I apologize for that if it's gonna look or sound weird with me, I'm clipped in championship, with my audio not syncing up. I may even just scrap this whole part if it sounds that stupid and re-record with something else. This is one that is on Rumble Racing. This is the passing through one. Put the start finish line kind of a weird. I really shouldn't use those jokers because it's usually going to be something bad. But this looks a little different, but it is the one on Rumble Racing. I think this is usually probably for like the beach portion of it, and there used to be like an actual jump here. Because you can do tricks in that game, and unfortunately you can't do tricks in this game. Which is really sad, because I thought that was really cool in Rumble Racing. It's probably why I like it better, is because you can do tricks, and in this one you can't. And I'm probably going to just dominate these first few championships. There's the boulders. I love the boulders in this track. Just because you have to play on Rookie, I can't put on No Mercy like I did for my Rumble Racing playthrough at the very beginning. For the Rookie class, you have to play on Rookie, the Pro, you have to race on Pro, and then Elite, you have to race on Elite. So, first couple of videos are probably going to be pretty boring because of that. But I guess that's good. Kind of gets me back in the groove of the game. But the one thing about this game is that it is more repetitive compared to Rumble Racing because you just go through the set of championships three times with all the different classes. Which kind of sucks, but I mean, what can you do? It was their first crack at it, so I don't necessarily mind. Let's see, I already have a 15-second lead on Earnhardt after one lap.
Make good use out of that.
Playing this game makes you wish that NASCAR was still on TV this time of year. Even though they have such a short offseason, I mean, it's like 2 months, 2 or 3 months, really. But I just miss it, because Sundays, even though I'm a casual football fan, they're just empty without being able to go home after work, since I freaking work almost every day now. Getting to go home from work and watch the race, it's just relaxing. I can wind down from working my retail job and dealing with people's stupid questions all the time. As you can tell, I love my job, but dealing with those, what the heck, dealing with those people just sucks. But hopefully, this next season is going to be much better, because I'm a Casey Kane fan. This past season sucked. It was like I was watching his 2007 season again, except this time he actually had decent cars half the time, but just either crashed, or had stupid pit strategy, or just lost a handle on the car. I mean, I still remember Texas, the fall race at Texas, where he drove to like second place. I was feeling good. I was like, he's gonna end on a good note. And then he stayed in like 16th after that. I mean, his pit crew first one sucks. He lost them like 8 positions in that race, and then he could never get it back. And then he crashes at the end. It was just, that was his season. Doing good in the beginning. Pretty much every race usually did fairly well in the beginning. Either lost a handle or did stupid pit strategy near the middle, and then probably crashed by the end. It was an absolute miracle he even made the chase, because he really just did not have the luck or the speed a lot of the times to really be in it. I'm actually surprised he made it to the second round and pretty much was going to make it into the third round. I don't know if you guys seen that video, but he was in the chase for the third round, like entering the tri-oval at Talladega, and then was out of it by 1 point exiting, and it would have been so hilarious if Casey Kane was the only Hendrick driver to make it on to the third round, and all three Hendrick drivers that I had to hear about, they were dominating, they were the best, and how Casey Kane just was sucking and not doing well. Casey Kane being the only one to move on when Junior, Jimmy, and Jeff, they got eliminated. It would have been awesome. Either way, the way the season went after Talladega, Casey Kane would not have done jack squat after that, but it still would have been hilarious. And if by some miracle he won the championship, it would have been awesome. Oh, crap. What luck. I was honestly, no offense to any fans of those three drivers, but I was hoping, just because me being a Casey Kane fan and having to hear how he just wasn't performing and that he sucked compared to the other drivers, even though Junior would have wished he would have had the season Casey Kane had instead of the season he did have in 2009 and 2010. Because, in 2009, Junior finished, 25th in points and had two top fives and four top tens. I mean, that's pathetic. At least Casey Kane won. But still, his season was bad. Especially for a Hendrick driver. Usually, they're a lot better than that. Usually, Casey Kane is better than that. But I guess we'll see. Hopefully, he'll have another season like 2012. Or even a mix between 2012 and 2013, that way he can lead more laps, because he led a lot of laps in 2013. Crap, get past this part. Crap. Well, I have a minute lead. It really doesn't matter. I hate this part here. Besides the boulders, I hate it. Must hit all the boulders and fly into the mountain. I really hope the audio is synced up well, because I really don't want to have to do this again. Or find a way, probably have to record my audio with Movie Maker and add it on second, which is a gimme pain, but because I really don't want to do post commentary. That's just boring.
It's good to be the king.
I'm boring, but it'll just make me even more boring. Let's see, 21 and a half minutes long. That's not too bad. If there was four races in these championships, I would definitely cut it half and half, but three, they'll just have to be long videos. Let's see, it's 1.4 gigs. God, it's probably going to take forever to upload. Oh well. Earnhardt made a pretty nice comeback in the championship, because he finished dead last the first race, and I think he finished fourth in the second race. Now, yeah, I think he's going to finish in second, but I'm not going to wait for them. I mean, I finished freaking, and look at my lap time compared to those guys. I mean, I finished a minute ahead of them. There's my record. There's my championship standings. Jeremy Mayfield. Look at all these names. None of these guys even race anymore. I don't even know who Scott Hansen is. I think that, was there a truck? Yeah, I think there was a truck racing. Yay, there was a gold. Championship took me 18 minutes and 10 seconds. And I unlocked a new bonus track, nice. And I got Alan Kulwicki, which I find funny that they put him as a legend. I mean, he is a champion, but I mean, I wouldn't consider him a legend. And Loader, that is the car/truck/Tonka truck that we unlocked with the gold wrench. Would I like to save game? Sure. Because I guess if this doesn't work out, just delete the save and retry again. So next time, I guess we'll play a little bit more Rumble Racing, first video I'm already doing that. I'm probably going to do that a whole lot. Next time we'll be playing more NASCAR Rumble. I think it's the city championship that's next. So see you guys.